This week is National School Lunch Week, and October is Farm to School Month. So we have some guests with us in studio today whose goal is all about making sure your kids get the nutrients that they need to stay alert and stay healthy. So joining us today is Cindy Long, right out of Washington, D.C., with the USDA. We have Bob Gorman, the former director of school nutrition at the Cleveland Metropolitan School District. Wave your hand, Bob. And Jamel Rakira, who's local, a local farmer from Village Family Farms. Thank you all so much for being here. I believe this is the first time we've ever had a salad bar rolled into the Fox 8 studios. So thank you. Very this good. Is exclusive for us. But Cindy, let's start with you because this has been your life's work.
Yep.
Really, your entire career. I mean, when you think about the history of food in the lunchroom, you think like at the beginning of time, like cold sandwiches in a noisy cafeteria, right? And then maybe some warm lunches, right? And then in the 70s, the McDonald's and all the fast food stuff that was coming in the schools, which is crazy.
Yep.
And then now today. So talk about USDA just passed something last year, right? Mm-hmm. So talk about that because it's new.
Yeah, absolutely. So you're right. National School Lunch Week is a great time to celebrate the incredible progress that has been made in
incredible.
The last 10 or 15 years. And just school lunches are not what many of the folks watching are going to remember.
Right.
I mean, this is what school lunches look like now. So, you know, we see so many more fruits and vegetables on the plate, whole grains, low fat dairy, everything you can think of. And it's really one of the really exciting things is there's more and more local food being served in schools. And you mentioned that we just updated some of the rules around school lunch. And we're continuing to support healthy eating, less sugar, less sodium. But one of the really important things that rule did was make it easier to buy local food.
Right.
So now we're encouraging schools to do that. And in fact, USDA and the Biden-Harris administration have been funding this kind of work to the greatest degree we can. In fact, just a week or so ago, we announced $500 million going into schools around the country to support the use of local foods in schools.
Right.
You know, we just see it as a big win-win. You get beautiful lunches like this. It's great for
Look
the local
the
economy. And it just broadens the supply chain and can even help, you know, make sure that we all have access to these great foods.
And Bob, talk about the farm to school program, because this is huge for you as well. We always say small changes make a big difference.
Right. Yes. Yeah, so currently we have fruit and veggie bars in about 23 of our schools. By the middle of March, we should have them in over 40 of them. And we're really excited to partner with local farms. All of our apples come from local farms. We partner with many small farmers around the city and throughout the state to purchase Sun Gold tomatoes, mini peppers, cucumbers to put on our fruit and veggie bars.
And then away from that, like breakfast, like what are we serving? I know eggs are important. So what are the things like a sample breakfast that has really changed over time?
Yeah, so one of the big things we've done is we tried to eliminate a lot of the quick breads at breakfast and we supplemented with like hard-boiled eggs, things of that nature, increased the fresh fruits at breakfast. So that's one of the things we've really tried to do, including adding some of the local items.
Now, I did read that you're still implementing some kind of fun stuff. Speaking for the kids, are there donuts and granola bars like every once in a while? Are we just strict now moving forward?
No more donuts.
No more
donuts.
But
we have partnered with a local company that makes a local granola bar. And the crew in the kitchens bake them off, and every day there is a local granola bar that's cooked and served to our students CMSD. And a lot of those ingredients within that granola bar are grown in Ohio and milled in Ohio.
Now, is chocolate milk staying?
Not for breakfast.
I got you, kids.
No, not for breakfast, no.
Okay, so we're all clear.
One of the first things we did is we got rid of the chocolate milk for breakfast. There's nothing worse than seeing a child pour chocolate milk in their Fruit Loops.
Exactly.
So we take that away for breakfast.
All right, so Jamel, you have supplied with your farm. I mean, we're talking Cleveland Metropolitan Schools, Parma Schools. This is huge for you guys. And a big thank you, I'm sure, for you guys
You're
as
welcome.
Well.
You're welcome. Yeah, it's really huge for us. This is actually our 10th year in operation for Village Family Farms, right? 10 years, a whole decade. We're located in a historic Huff neighborhood. And so to have this relationship, we were actually doing programming with CMSD, working with students on tours and workshops beforehand. But to have this relationship really speaks volumes. It supports Urban Ag. I actually sit on the Urban Ag Committee of Cleveland.
Yeah.
That's an elected position. So we actually bring resources to Cleveland, to other urban farmers. But to have this relationship, working with the USDA, working with CMSD to, you know, source produce from us, it only adds to our bottom line. It only adds to the industry, the emerging industry of Urban Ag. And it, you know, when you're talking about healthy students, you're talking about healthy communities and healthy cities. So,
yeah,
you know, it fits right in line with our mission of providing the freshest fruits and vegetables to those who otherwise wouldn't have access.
Now, do you talk with the schools to kind of get the kids' perspective on like what they like at those particular schools, or just is what's in season at the moment that we implement into the schools?
Usually, the students, like, you know, they may not like like tomatoes, but once they get the taste of a vine-ripened tomato,
they eat them
like cherries, right?
Yes.
And so with peppers, you know, we did some programming at Almira Elementary School over on the west side, and to see students eating fresh peppers, right?
Yeah.
You know, with no sauce or anything, it really, you know, it spoke volumes.
And Bob, that's a good question for you. How are the kids responding to this? To get my kids to eat something like this at my house, mm-hmm. it could be difficult.
And that's what Farm to School is all about. It's not only providing that fresh local produce, it's about the education piece too. In Cleveland Metropolitan School District, we've entered a partnership with Food Corps. So we have members going into our schools, educating students about fresh local produce, and that's teaching them, that's educating them. We've had partnerships with Jamel and other farmers that are coming into our schools that's also encouraging them to eat the fresh produce or at least try it.
And
then when they go on the farm visits, Jamel lives right up next to one of our schools. They just had a field trip last week.
The field trips, and then they can take that and implement. I think we could talk more about this for a long time, but we appreciate you, Jamel, for everything you're doing at your farm. Bob, for what you've been doing as well, and Cindy making this your life's work and traveling all around the country. Make our kids healthy.
Absolutely.
All right, kids, to the salad bar.